لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار عباد الله نقف اليوم مع درس من دروس الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أعرف الناس بربه وأخشاهم وأتقاهم له وكثيراً بل دائماً ما كان يضرع إلى ربه في الدعاء وفي الدعاء الذي سأقرأه عليكم اليوم من رواية عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما وأخرجه الإمام مسلم في صحيحه في كتاب الدعوات قال عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما كان من دعاء الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم إني أعوذ بك من زوال نعمتك وتحول عافيتك وفجاءة نقمتك وجميع سخطك. In this authentic hadith narrated by Muslim in his Sahih on the authority of Abdullah ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with both of them, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to supplicate to his Lord with this dua, saying, O Allah, I seek refuge in you, that your blessings are lifted and your protection of me is changed. And I seek refuge in you from the suddenness of your punishment and from all your anger. So this hadith is narrated in Sahih Muslim and also in the Sunan of Abi Dawood. Let's together try to reflect on this beautiful dua by our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is teaching this all the time, we shouldn't wait until we have a calamity, until we face problems, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In his advice to Abdullah ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with both of them, Abdullah and his father, he said, تعرف على الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. Recognize your Lord, remember your Lord Obey your Lord. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you are at ease, comfortable, things are running smoothly. Remember Allah at that time. Obey Allah at that time. If you do that, Allah will recognize you, will be with you, will help you in rough and tough times. When you face difficulties and trials, Allah will be with you. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam here is asking Allah to continue blessing him with his bounties. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min zawali ni'matik. Your favors on me, your blessings, your bounties that you gave to me, please, O Allah, don't withdraw them. Don't take them away. So what are the blessings of Allah? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. You cannot count the blessings of Allah. They are countless. But what's the most important ni'mah and favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The best, the most important one, that He made you a Muslim. The favor of faith, ni'matul Islam, wa ni'matul Iman. هذه النعمة قد تسلب منك. هذه النعمة قد تحرمها بمعاصيك وإعراضك عن دين الله. This bounty might be withdrawn from you. It was given to you by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He can take it from you if you don't fulfill its requirements. Every single bounty or favor you have, whether it's that peace of mind, that tranquility, security and safety, health, wealth, spouse, children, you name it, it's all from Allah. And Allah has stated that clearly in the Quran. Allah said, وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. The translation, and whatever you have of favor, whatever it is, small or significant, moral or physical, spiritual, all the blessings are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me read to you what Shaykh al-Mufassirin mentioned in the tafsir of this ayah. قال رحمه الله ما يكن بكم في أبدانكم أيها الناس من عافية وصحة وسلامة وفي أموالكم من نماء فالله المنعم عليكم بذلك لا غيره لأن ذلك إليه وبيده وتتمة الآية ثم إذا مسكم الضر يقول إذا أصابكم في أبدانكم سقم ومرض وعلة عارضة وشدة من عيش فإليه تجأرون يقول فإلى الله تصرخون بالدعاء وتستغيثون به ليكشف ذلك عنكم. So the Mufassir, the commentator, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari is saying, whatever blessing from Allah, whether it's a healthy body, security and safety, the wealth you have, it is Allah alone, not any other source, is the source, the only source who gave it to you. And the completion of the ayah, it says, when adversity touches you, to Him you cry for help. He say to Allah alone, you cry in supplication, seeking help to save you and to help you and to remove that adversity that touched you. Ibn Kathir is commenting on the same verse. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. What's his comment? He said, أَخْبَرَ أَنَّهُ مَالِكُ النَّفْعِ وَالضُّرِّ وَأَنَّ مَا بِالْعِبَادِ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَنِعْمَةٍ وَعَافِيَةٍ وَنَصْرٍ فَمِنْ فَضْلِهِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَإِحْسَانِهِ إِلَيْهِمْ ثُمَّ إِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فَإِلَيْهِ تَجْأَرُونَ. أي لعلمكم أنه لا يقدر على إزالته إلا هو. So when calamity touches you remember Allah and you know at that time it's only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who can help you, who can save you subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, we have to remember Allah all the time and we have to be thankful. We have to be grateful. And that is very important when we are in a time of peace, security, safety, prosperity. We shouldn't ever forget Allah and that all what we have came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min zawali ni'matik. So the source of the ni'mah from where? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's the most important ni'mah as I mentioned? It's Islam. It's Iman. Because all what you can possess in this life has no value whatsoever. You will leave it behind you when you enter that hole in the ground. I and you. أسأل الله لي ولكم حسن الخاتمة. So it has no value whatsoever. The most important thing is dinuk, imanuk. That's what you have and you should guard. And the church. And try to invest time and effort to make it even stronger. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning this fact in Surah Yunus. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا هو خير مما يجمعون. Say, in the bounty of Allah and His mercy, in that let them rejoice. It is better than what they accumulate. So here, the commentator again is making the tafsir of this ayah. قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا هو خير مما يجمعون. يقول ابن جرير الطبري يقول تعالى ذكره لنبيه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم قل يا محمد لهؤلاء المشركين بك وبما أنزل إليك من عند ربك بفضل الله أيها الناس الذي تفضل به عليكم وهو الإسلام فبينه لكم ودعاكم إليه وبرحمته التي رحمكم بها فأنزلها إليكم فعلمكم ما لم تكونوا تعلمون من كتابه وبصركم بها معالم دينكم وذلك القرآن. المقصود به القرآن. فبذلك فليفرح هو خير مما يجمعون. يقول فإن الإسلام الذي دعاهم إليه والقرآن الذي أنزله عليهم خير مما يجمعون من حطام الدنيا وأموالها وكنوزها. So what's the most thing that we should celebrate with, be happy with? It is fadlullah, the grace of Allah, and the tafsir, the grace of Allah, is that He guided you to become a Muslim. It is not by your strength. It is just the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he mentioned. And then wa rahmatihi, his mercy, and it meant here the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with. If you have the iman, if you are loyal to the Quran, taking care of it, then be happy. Be proud. It is what people are accumulating of the wealth of this life, or posts, or fame. It cannot even be compared with the belief, with that yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that we will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we will be asked about these favors. Did we appreciate it? Did we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it? جعلني الله عز وجل وإياكم من الشاكرين لنعمه وأسأل الله أن يديم علينا نعمه أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أعود فأقرأ عليكم حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، تأملوه وادعوه بقلوب موقنة. Reflect on this dua, and when you supplicate to Allah, be certain that He hears you and He can answer your call. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من زوال نعمتك وتحول عافيتك وفجاءة نقمتك وجميع سخطك. So what's the difference زوال نعمتك وتحول عافيتك? What's the difference between these two? زوال النعمة يعني ذهابها بالكلية، وتحول العافية انتقالها إلى صورة ربما أقل. So زوال النعمة, that these blessings will be taken completely, but تحول العافية maybe it will be decreased. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is asking both. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one day was talking to the Sahaba that he will answer their call, said then we will increase. إذا نكثر. The Prophet ﷺ said, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Don't, when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask beg. Ask al-Jannah, ask al-Firdaus al-A'la, ask to have the company of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the scholars mentioned that there is a way to safeguard, to protect the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this safeguard is mentioned in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. I'll conclude with this point here, that the scholar said, you can protect the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from being withdrawn from you or decreased if you apply this ayah. Allah says, and remember when your Lord proclaimed. So this is a declaration by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His authentic book. If you are grateful, I will surely increase you in favor. Allah is declaring, if you are grateful, I will surely increase you in favor. This is a law. This is a law. And this is a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَئِن كَفَرْتُمْ, but if you deny, indeed my punishment is severe. So كَفَرْتُمْ, here the scholar said, كفر النعمة, to be ungrateful. So if you wanna be grateful, how to be grateful? Of course you say Alhamdulillah all the time, but also to apply the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which are given to you by Him in a way that pleases Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you health, use it, utilize it, enjoy it in a way that does not displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you wealth, say Alhamdulillah, but also be grateful by saying, by using this money, spending it in ways that it pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a matter of fact, this hadith has lots of lessons, but I can see that we passed the allocated time and you will go back for work. You can look up this hadith and its translation online. It's in Sahih Muslim. And let me repeat it for the third time. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من زوال نعمتك وتحول عافيتك وفجاءة نقمتك وجميع سخطك. اللهم أحسن ختامنا, اللهم تب علينا, اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت. اللهم بلغنا رمضان, اللهم بلغنا رمضان, اللهم بلغنا رمضان, واعتق رقابنا في هذا الشهر يا رب العالمين, شهر رمضان. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم, وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.